always tune in to the weekly Top 40, mainly because I want to find out who is going to be number one. But have you, like me, ever wondered how this...
Bruno Brooks.
Good afternoon and welcome to Europe's biggest radio show, 1FM's official UK Top 40.
Gets to hear. And where does this place fit in? So how do you fit into this chain? Is this the first link?
Yeah, this is the first link of the chain. We're the first port to call for the records. We buy all the records in, and as those records are sold, that information gets collated by the Gallup machine.
How do you process it all through to the Gallup house?
All the sales throughout the day are put through this machine here, and they in turn are passed on to Gallup every evening.
From you here?
From this machine. At close of business tonight, the machine will have a cut-off point. All the sales throughout the day, collected throughout the day on this machine, will get processed onto Gallup through the telephone lines.
What's the most popular format for singles?
A CD single is the most popular format.
Yeah.
Probably second, followed by the cassette single, mm-hmm. and vinyl last.
The next stop is here at the Gallup House, which is where I've been told I could find the real stars of the charts. So I'm quite excited because it could be anybody like Whitney Houston, Madonna, maybe Bryan Adams. Take that. John, can you explain to me exactly what Gallup's role is in compiling the charts?
Well, we collect sales from record shops all around the country, and in effect, we're measuring which is the best-selling records each week.
How many shops do you collect all your information from?
In total, 1,500 shops scattered all around the UK.
And what do they have to have or do that makes them selected?
Well, we select on three criteria. First of all, the region of the shop and which town it's in, what part of the country it's in. Secondly, what type of shop it is, whether it's a chain or whether it's an independent or a specialist type shop. And finally, what the size of the shop it is, whether it's large or small.
We saw them scanning all the records in the shop. So what happens when it actually comes through here?
Well, we collect the sales from the main computer, which dials out at midnight every night and collects the sales from the record shops down the telephone lines. The last dial out is Saturday night, and by Sunday morning we have usually over 1 million sales collected from the 1,500 record shops around the country. We brought computers into the business, and that speeds it up, it makes it easier to check the information. And it's, all in all, it's a lot more accurate now than it's ever been.
And would you say it's very easy to fiddle or cheat it, or not?
It's pretty difficult now. No system in the world can be 100% foolproof, but we think we're 99.9% now. With 1 million sales a week, it's very difficult to try and distort that.
And how does the whole system relate to Radio 1?
Well, Sunday morning we put all the sales together. We work out which is the best-selling records, and we rank all the records, and we fax that over to Radio 1 just in time for the show on Sunday.
Well, I've been to the record shop, to Gallup House, and now I find myself here at Radio 1 FM on a Sunday afternoon, just about in time for Bruno Brooks' chart show. And if I hurry, I may just see those charts come hot off that fax. Well, not only have I managed to get into Radio 1, I've managed to find my way to the fax, which is currently, as I speak, sending through the fax from the Gallup poll with the top 40. So the exciting thing is as I'm the first person, the only person here, I'm going to be able to reveal to you exclusively who is number one, because I have it right here. And, wow, you're not going to believe this.
I think that's meant for me, you know, that fax.
Oh, yes.
You remember? Me?
Yes. Sorry, it's your show, isn't it?
It's my show. Remember?
Slight problem. Okay. So you won't let me reveal who's number one yet, then?
I'm afraid not, no. And I'm afraid I'm just going to have to tell everybody on the air later on the top 40.
Right, okay. So, I won't say a word, honestly. Nothing.
Okay.
I tried. What can I say?
Come in here, then. This is the top 40 production office.
Wow.
Yeah.
Is this a kind of one-man show? Do you organise everything to do
everything.
With it?
I do the whole thing.
Oh, really?
Well, not quite everything. This is Alison over here. As you can see, she's typing away on a keyboard there. Basically, when we get the facts from Gallup, that's just the brief bones of the information.
Right.
And so then what we've got to do is we've got to collect all the records together, make sure the durations are right, and Alison then puts it into some sort of Latin script
right.
That And I'll be using it a bit later on.
And what about this man here? What
does this man here is he's just sort of acting as if he can type on a keyboard. This is Ivor, he's the producer of the show. Say hi, Ivor.
Hi, Ivor.
See, well trained.
Oh, right, so he's the producer of the whole thing.
Yeah, he's the producer. What does the producer do, Ivor? I'm not sure.
Yeah, what does he do?
He keeps the jocks in order. Make sure he's here on time.
That's it.
Make sure he's what are you typing, Ivor?
Actually, at the moment I'm doing the dance chart because we're going to include the dance chart in the UK Top 40 as well as other charts.
How long have you been doing this show for now?
7 years. I had a break from the show for 2 years. Mark Goodger did it for a couple of years, but 7 years all told. Yeah, long time.
And do you still get really excited announcing the top 40?
I do. First thing I do is obviously see that information that comes over from Gallup. Remember that piece of paper you tried to steal from me earlier?
Yes.
Yeah, absolutely. And, no, it's nice. And through the week, I try and predict in my own mind what's going to be number one or, you know, highest new entry and so on. So it's still exciting, of course.
And are you always right?
No. In my predictions?
Yeah.
No, I get the surprise, and that's why I get excited.
Now, what's the difference between this and the network charts?
Well, there's a lot of difference between this and the network chart, which is that still on the air, incidentally?
I don't know, I never listened to it.
Right, okay. I did get a recording of it sent to me by a listener.
Yes.
A couple of months ago. But the difference is that, first of all, this is the official Top 40, and that's recognised by the entire record industry, not only in this country, but in Europe and in America. And what that means is that all the pop stars and all those people who make the records, the producers, they believe that if they're doing well in this chart, then that's all that counts.
Now, live from 1FM in London, the official UK Top 40 with Bruno Brooks.
Good afternoon and welcome to Europe's biggest radio show, 1FM's official UK Top 40. Every week, you and 9 million other people join the stars to hear the only official countdown of the 40 biggest selling singles in the United Kingdom over the last 7 days. Taking in all the sales until midnight last night, 1FM's UK Top 40 is computer compiled and it's the only chart used by the entire record industry, both here and abroad. Last week, Meatloaf spent a second week at the top of the chart. Will he still be there today, or will Capella or Bryan Adams push him off the top? Stand by for the next 3 hours on 97 to 99 for the only chart that counts on the world's biggest radio station. But first, last week's number one. And now